Last week on the Game Boob Show. Game, so you don't have to. Now, first, I like to bring up my mustache. It turns out, you see, that I lost a football bet. I bet that the Chicago Cubs would strip naked and proceed to do some rectal spelunking on the 50-yard line. And they didn't. Yet. So I'm forced to grow this, even though the idea of being forced to grow feces hair is retarded, and I could have easily explained the real reason why.
I'm not wasting your time!
Now let's get down to business. Now, as all of you in the know, I've got a chubby checkered history with Marwin. I've had to do his fuck platypals, his addictive pills. Well, it turns out that Marwin made another RPG game, and it's called Super Marwin RPG Legend of the Seven Samurai. I take a look at this RPG thing, and nobody I know knows what RPG is known to stand for. But I do, it stands for repugnant, and in this game, makes me want to burn out my eyeballs with battery acid. This game makes me want to
waste your time.
Wait a bit, you notice that this RPG game is different than its perfect RPG successor, Dr. Marwin. Where are the pills, the Miley Cyruses, the pyro, the flash funk? Instead, we have this. I don't believe it. Where are Marwin's red overalls? That isn't the Marwin of my childhood!
I don't believe it! I'm so stressed out! I can't even concentrate! Here! This is the classic Marwin! I bought this when I was 42 years old! Look! Green overalls! Is that so hard to understand?
It appears that we have a caller, and this is not a call-in show. Hello, you're connected via by phone.
It's an old joke. Two elderly women are at a Catskill Mountain Resort, and one of them says, "Boy, the food and spice is really
I know I can't disconnect the phone myself, but could someone cut the speed? Phew. No more offensive Italian stereotypes. Anyways, as I was playing the game, I noticed something that made me notice something. Link and the Master Blader made camouflages in this game. Talking about obvious product placement to talk about. Luckily, I'm not like that at all, in spite of this obviously bad joke that Stevie Blunder could have seen a mile away. So the plot is, you guessed it, Princess Leia has been kidnapped.
Of course!
And Marwin has to save her. I like the fact that this game has you only play the final level. That's how all games should be. But what is this? I can't jump on him?
What is this shit? I need to fight them and then wait my turn? What are you doing? This doesn't even make no second lightest! No green overalls and no jumping!
I apologize for that. It's just that you see, well, it's just...
No jumping! I know where I am! Wait, my penis! I can't hear you!
Anyways, since you can't use your jumping, you have to use your...
Fist of Dog Funny!
And it turns out that you can't even beat Gamora! You have to beat his chain!
As long as I don't have to beat Gamora's meat,
Oh, we have another phone call. It's probably that Swedish stereotype again, and since I'm an idiot, I'm gonna waste your time. I'm gonna answer it even though I shouldn't. Hello, you're connected via the phone, which is via my hand transmitting via to my ears.
The other important joke for me is one that's usually attributed to Groucho Marx, but I think it appears originally in Freud's Wit and Its Relation to the Unconscious. And it goes like this, I'm paraphrasing. I would never want to belong to any club that would have someone like me for a member.
So after 50 years of gameplay, I'm finally able to beat Gamora and save Queen Amidala. But wait a minute. There's another villain in a Marwin game. You took away my classic Green Amidala! Continue to a field game that's different from the normal norm. I want things to stay as they normally are. Anything different confuses and scares me. So this is a special game, Boob. Go tuck yourself in the Super Mario RPG. I'm the Game Boob. I play bad games, so you don't have to. Oh shit, wrong way.
One of those days, fucker, it's just one of those days. I think you better shit.